Senator Ted Cruz, a Republican from Texas, sits on the Senate Judiciary Committee, joins us now. Senator, good to have you back on Fox News at night.
Shannon, always good to be with you.
All right, I want to play something. These are folks, your colleagues from both sides of the aisle, their assessment of what they heard behind closed doors today.
I came away from this briefing really angry, deeply dissatisfied that after waiting this long for the facts that justified the killing of the second in command of a foreign government, that the answers were unacceptably vague and unspecific.
Probably the worst briefing I've seen, at least on a military issue, in the 9 years I've served in the United States Senate.
Not surprising that you and Mr. Blumenthal may not agree on things, but you and Mr. Lay are pretty tight. He wasn't impressed.
Well, sure, and I think you're looking at two very different things. When it comes to Blumenthal and when it comes to the Senate Democrats and the House Democrats, look, it's no surprise that they're opposed to President Trump. They're opposed to President Trump on everything. And actually, when it comes to taking out Soleimani, Soleimani was the worst terrorist on the face of the planet. And taking him out was a major victory for keeping America safe. And yet, Senate Democrats, House Democrats, they're not interested in the facts. They're not interested. They're not even willing to admit that he was a terrorist because their Trump derangement trumps everything else. Now, when it comes to Mike Lee, as you know, Mike is a dear, dear friend. I think Mike was frustrated because the administration, particularly when asked some forward-looking questions about what level of congressional authorization and congressional consultation was necessary, I think the administration was a little too quick to dismiss the role of Congress. Listen, I'm a believer in the Constitution. Mm-hmm. Under the Constitution, it is Congress that has the power to declare war. And I think any time you're looking at long-term sustained military engagement, you need congressional authorization. That's what Mike was reacting to, is the administration was pretty dismissive of that. But that being said, taking out Soleimani, America's safer as a result of this. And I got to say, Blumenthal's take on it, I thought was ridiculous, because I heard that same briefing. We heard from the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. We heard from the Secretary of Defense. We heard from the head of the CIA that Soleimani had for decades carried out a campaign of murdering Americans. The Department of Defense has said Soleimani is directly responsible for the murder of over 603 American servicemen and women. And just in recent days, he had directed an attack that had killed an American contractor and had directed an attack on our embassy. And that resulted in a direct action to take him out. And that was the right thing to do.
Yeah. And that led to what we saw last night, which was Iran's response. Although the Ayatollah says it's not over, there is more to come to settle the score. Both you and the president talked about the fact that the Iran nuclear deal under the Obama administration sent cash over to Iran that may have directly funded what we saw last night.
Yes.
The AP and a fact check says this: the administration's offered no information supporting the contention that in regaining access to $150 billion of its assets that had been frozen abroad, Iran steered a chunk of that money to the missiles that hit the bases in Iraq. Iran has many sources of revenue, despite the severe pinch of sanctions. Oil sales to China and other countries dominate its exports. It also sells chemicals, plastics, fruits, and more abroad. So, Senator, is it taking a leap to link the two things, the Iran nuke deal and those missiles last night?
Look, I got to say, the behavior of AP and mainstream media to defend Iran, to defend the Ayatollah Khamenei, and to serve as essentially apologists for the enemy of America, it's really sad. And I get, they don't like Donald Trump. That is not lost on anybody. The media has lost their minds. Many congressional Democrats have lost their mind. But listen, here's a very simple principle. Money is fungible. Under Barack Obama, under the catastrophic Obama-Iran nuclear deal, the United States allowed between $100 billion and $150 billion to flow directly into Iran. The Obama administration sent $1.7 billion in cash in unmarked bills on pallets in the dead of night in a plane flown into Iran late at night. That money is fungible, and when you flood the Ayatollah, who is chanting death to America, with over $100 billion, in a very real sense, that money that the Obama administration allowed to flow into Iran is what helped fund those missiles that were attacking our servicemen and women last night.
Let me make sure that I want to ask you about impeachment, too, before we have to let you go, because there's talk now that there could be a trial as soon as next week. Speaker Nancy Pelosi, in a letter earlier this week, says the process is not only unfair, but designed to deprive senators and the American people of crucial documents and testimony. Sounds like Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell is ready to move ahead despite the demands from the speaker. Is there going to be a trial next week? What can you tell us?
Well, listen, I hope so. That these articles of impeachment are going to be thrown out is not coming remotely close to the constitutional standard. If Pelosi sends them over, the Senate's going to conduct a fair trial. We're going to respect due process, unlike the House. We're going to let both the House managers and the president defend themselves, present their case, and then judging on the constitutional standard, I'm confident that these facially deficient articles of impeachment are going to be thrown out.
Well, you will be one of the jurors if that indeed comes to fruition, and whenever it does. Senator Ted Cruz, thanks for joining us tonight. Good to see you.
Always a pleasure.